And greetings and welcome to the second of our random drawing winner showcase videos for the first week of our Morrowind's May Marathon Month modding competition. Again, for those of you just tuning in, we're celebrating Morrowind's 16th anniversary by hosting a month-long modding competition where modders can submit mods, win prizes and achievements, and get special showcase videos like this one. And anyway, having said that, today we're going to be taking a look at Tel Uvirith LITE by Ashraw, so far the only house mod submitted for the competition, which is rather impressive considering we've had over 30 mods submitted so far. And anyway, this is just a really cool looking and a bit of an underrated mod, and hopefully this showcase will, you know, direct a bit more attention to it. And anyway, download links are down below, so let's get right into the showcase, shall we? This is quite obviously an overhaul expansion of the famed Tel Uvirith Telvanni stronghold, located out in the dreary and forlorn landscape of the Molag Amur region. And right away, one of the first things you'll notice here along the exterior is a lot more, you know, crazy Telvanni roots just shooting off everywhere, as well as a lot more lanterns and multicolored lights to give this lonely Telvanni tower a much more, you know, sort of atmospheric and welcoming look that I think is, you know, a pretty big improvement here. And anyway, there's also a new guest house that's been added in here, which we'll be taking a closer look at here in a second, and also a new sort of a smaller tower room that's been added to the top of the Telvanni tower here. And overall, this is just a really scenic visual overhaul. I especially love how this place looks during the evening and nighttime hours, and when you get the full effect of the dozens of new light sources here. And of course, needless to say, this will, you know, conflict with Uvirith's legacy and most other house mods for Tel Uvirith. Though, having said that, it should still work with LG and PC Tel Uvirith, and possibly even, you know, building up Uvirith's grave, though I haven't actually, you know, tested those yet myself. But anyway, moving on, we're just going to check out the guest house here, which is just a really beautiful and cozy abode, complete with bedrolls, a fire pit, and a fair number of containers. And really, I just love the cozy and atmospheric interior design here. It's just an incredibly welcoming place to come upon after an ash storm, or, you know, a long journey through the Molag Amur region. And you also find a number of documents just scattered throughout this home, presumably left by your character, detailing the notes of their various experiments and whatnot. And now, just heading into the main tower here. This mod doesn't really change that much with the lower tower, but it does, you know, lightly expand the upper tower with a new alchemy ingredient garden, with just a fair number of plants to harvest here. And of course, you know, don't forget to look up to find more. There's also been an overhaul made to the dining room, with more flowers and Telvanni shelves and miscellaneous clutter just strewn around here, which is again just a really nice looking and atmospheric, you know, touch-up for this room. But the really big changes to Tel Uvirith can be found downstairs in the dungeon, which has seen a major overhaul, including a complete redesign of the, you know, entry area here, adding more cozy and comfy-looking quarters with Telvanni shelves for storage and display, the occasional Telvanni table you can just dine with a light snack, or, you know, what have you, and large piles of pillows that provide some really comfy-looking seating arrangements where you can just sit back and enjoy a book, or just relax after a long day of experimenting with a variety of different spells. The interior design here is really just perfection, and we haven't even gotten to the best part yet. And speaking of, we're just going to hop straight to my absolute favorite part of this house mod, the Fungal Observatory, which is quite possibly the most creative and unique looking interior I've seen all year. It's just absolutely beautiful and breathtaking, and it's basically a large hollow cavern with a bedroom, you know, just floating on a platform in the middle here, surrounded by hundreds of stars. Only those aren't stars. Those are actually hundreds of luminescent mushrooms patterned along the ceiling and walls here in the form of constellations. And again, this room is just amazing, I love everything about it, and this one room alone is an excellent argument for why you should give this mod a try. There's just nothing else quite like it. And I mean, after all, who wouldn't want their master bedroom to look upon the stars? And the way that Ashraw has accomplished this is so perfectly Telvanni that it just makes perfect sense for a Telvanni wizard. And just real quick, I do need to make a slight disclaimer here. I accidentally used the wrong version of Tel Uvirith LITE here when recording the showcase. There's two main versions, one for improved Telvanni meshes, and also one for, you know, regular vanilla Telvanni meshes, and I accidentally used the wrong one here. So you might notice some slight object clipping here, but no worries, if you use the right version, you shouldn't have any of that in your own game. And moving on, we're next going to be taking a look at the alchemy lab here, which is actually directly connected to the Fungal Observatory, including some basic alchemical equipment, nothing too fancy or overpowered, and also just another little, you know, flavor document here. And really, while this is a small interior, it's still rather lovely. And now another small chamber that you'll find here is this rather cozy and close-quartered cafe, which has a lovely pool of floating candles, a number of tables and chairs to seat any number of guests, and a small kitchen area. And much like the rest of this expansion here, it's all rather nicely and atmospherically decorated. And there's even a rather a neat little functional armor to this cafe, as you'll find by the notes left by the stove here. And this just allows you to brew some trauma root coffee to drink. Now, one of the final rooms we'll be taking a look at here is a set of cabin chambers, including a small bathing area, and you'll notice a number of friendly Doomer Centurions hanging around, as well as the occasional flying book, because of course, you know, this is a wizard's home after all. And also in here, you'll find a ton of mushrooms, just, you know, covering the floor and walls here. And up above, you'll find a small private bedroom and chambers, including a bed obviously, a small side lounge, some display and storage areas, and even a couple of, you know, small magical workshops. And you'll notice the sense of verticality in this cabin area is just absolutely fantastic, with little nooks and crannies practically right on top of each other, with Telvanni stairways and routes going between them. And yes, you'll probably need to use, you know, levitation to get around in here. Just take a hint from the flying books, which you'll just see flying around here and there. And while this is the last room we're going to be taking a look at here, please note that we're skipping over a few things, because there's just a ton of hidden things for you to discover in this abode, and I don't want to spoil everything. But there is just one more thing to take a look at here. This one adds a number of curse books scattered throughout this entire home for you to find. And when you read them, they unlock special and sometimes very strange spells that'll appear in your spellbook here. And some of them have some pretty interesting stories to tell, so just keep an eye out for those. And all in all, this is just a fantastic lightweight overhaul and expansion to Tel Uvirith. You know, pretty much perfect for those looking for something a bit smaller than a Uvirith's Legacy, and I really can't recommend it enough. And at the risk of playing favorites, this is one of my favorite mods submitted for the competition so far, and the quality on display here is especially amazing, considering this is Ashraw's first ever mod, and I can only hope we'll see even more mods from them going into the future. And anyway, that about wraps up the showcase here. Again, download links are down below, so please do, you know, check this mod out. And anyway, we'll be back on Sunday with another random drawing winner showcase video. So until then, thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time!